Earlier this year, the Brazilian government announced over $800 million worth of support to further value addition in country. And top of the list is really how they can extract the full value of the rare earths and the rare earth endowment in Brazil. So between ourselves and our partners in VMM, we've been working on that, and we are looking at how we can help facilitate.
It's been a big couple of days for Ionic Rare Earths. It has not only inked a non-binding MOU with UK-based sustainable materials leader EMR to establish a circular supply chain for rare earth magnets, but has also, through its Viridion joint venture, delivered its first shipment of recycled rare earth oxides to Brazilian magnet manufacturing partners. Here to discuss this latest achievement is Managing Director Tim Harrison. Tim, it's good to see you.
Hi, Jonathan. Good to be back.
It's welcome. So let's start with today's announcements. Talk us through the shipment, what it includes, and what it means for Ionic Rare Earths.
Yeah, so Ionic Rare Earths is part of our Brazilian joint venture with Viridis Mining and Minerals. We have the Viridion JV, which is looking at developing both refinery capacity and also magnet recycling in Brazil. So the announcement today represents, quite a bit of work that's gone into this partnership and the supply chain in Brazil for some time. Effectively, we took end-of-life magnets from applications, wind turbines, and MRIs. We shipped those materials to the UK, where they were processed through our demonstration facility in Belfast, produced the high-purity oxides, and now they've gone back into Brazil. To go to Brazilian magnet manufacturer lab fab to start the next phase of de developing and demonstrating Brazilian capacity in metals, alloys, and magnet manufacturing.
And we'll get to what's going on in the UK in a second, but can you talk me through? I think it's important to I guess flesh out what the recycling process is and how it's different from traditional mining and how it helps the environment, etc.
Yeah, so the recycling activity that we're doing on permanent magnets, so we take the end-of-life magnets, we crush, we grind them, we digest them. That enables us to separate the rare earths away from the base metals, the iron, and other materials in the alloy. Once that's separated, we then put it through a solvent extraction process where we're able to separate it into the individual magnet rare earth oxides. So we've produced those oxides, and we're able to do it with a substantially lower carbon footprint. We don't have anywhere near the tailings produced from the process, and we don't have any of the radionuclide issues. So, there's a fundamental step change on the environmental aspects of recycling and the materials we can produce through recycling. And we can also develop this capacity in the backyard of Western governments, which is hugely attractive, certainly given the geopolitical nature of rare earths, as we've seen over the last, 8 weeks or so.
So you mentioned you bring it all back to Brazil. How important is it, and the work that you're doing at the CIT-SENAI facility as well, how important is it for local magnet production there?
Look, it's a big part of value addition strategy that the Brazilian government is working on now. Earlier this year, the Brazilian government announced over $800 million worth of support to further value addition in country. And top of the list is really how they can extract the full value of the rare earths and the rare earth endowment in Brazil. So between ourselves and our partners in VMM, we've been working on that. And we are looking at how we can help facilitate that. What we're doing now in Brazil is sort of mapping out the next stage of commercializing and demonstrating that capability through both refining and recycling, and building capability in Brazil that can ultimately start that domestic and secure supply chain and enable the Brazilian primary supply to ultimately flow into that in years to come.
So yeah, look, big things to come in Brazil, but also big things to come, as you mentioned, in the UK as well. Can you talk us through the partnership with EMR and what you hope to achieve?
Yeah, so EMR is a large sustainable recycler, substantial footprint in the UK, but also a very substantial footprint in Europe and the US. So as a partner, they will help us now with the security of supply for the recycling or a portion thereof of the material that we'll be looking to recycle through a Belfast facility. And so the MOU that we've announced with them is really the first step of a number of steps that we're working on at the moment, which is around demonstrating the ability to take diverse feed from a number of end-of-life applications and recycle that back into high purity oxides in the UK for further value addition, further industrial application, and ultimately supporting, a key plank of the UK's ambitions on both energy security, but also net zero ambitions. So, it's a really important piece of the puzzle now as we look at commercializing magnet recycling in the UK.
So big opportunities in what in all that you're doing, really.
Yeah, look, and this is the thing. It's taken a lot of work to get to this point, and there will be multiple things that sort of flow from this. But yeah, look, really pleased now to be able to talk publicly about the collaboration with EMR, and I know the team in the UK is pretty excited about what's coming next.
So just finally, Tim, what is coming next?
Yeah, look, we continue to work on commercialization of the technology. We've been working on the grant application in the UK and working through that process with stakeholders. It's not just the development of one facility. There's multiple other aspects of the supply chain that are going to be built in the UK. And so whilst we have been patient as we work through this process with the UK government, we've got visibility on a number of factors that are also happening around the periphery. The progress in the UK, we've got visibility on the milestones that we've passed, and hopefully we're very close now on finalising the grant for commercialisation of the technology in the UK.
Yeah, Tim, plenty to look forward to. And yeah, we'll speak again as it all unfolds. But thanks for your time today.
Thanks, Jonathan.